Is that you, boy?
Yes, it's me, Dillan.
Marsha's boy? Well, I'll be. You must be twice as big as the last time I seen you. What you doing here?
Mom dropped me off.
She didn't want to come see me?
She was in a hurry.
In a hurry to go where? That boyfriend of hers ever get what's coming to him? He hurt you? What you got in the poke there, boy? What's the matter? Chicken?
Can I have something to drink?
Whatever's in the fridge. Tastes better with chocolate syrup.
Where can I sleep?
Well, when it ain't raining, in the garret. Garret, up there.
Thank you.
Yeah, she dropped him off here yesterday. You might want to walk back real slow. Lord. Hey, kid! Hey! Hey, you!
What do you want?
My name's Jason. Hey, you don't have to be afraid of me, buddy. What's your name?
Dillan.
Dillan, huh? Well, listen here, Dillan. I've got this problem. I've got all this cream soda stacked up in my shop over here that I'm trying to get rid of. Can you give me a hand with it?
I'm sorry, but I have to go.
Okay. Well, hey, we'll catch you next time, all right? Hey, you know, if you're walking because your car broke down, I could fix it for you. Oil changes are half off first time around. It's all part of our friendly service over here. I thought it.
Mechanic?
Well, actually, let me tell you something. That's just my cover. Really, it's the ideal in contraband soda.
But can you fix broken things?
What'd you break? Your Cadillac?
No. The police took it for drunk driving.
Drunk driving, huh? Wow. Maybe I should get something a little bit stronger than cream soda for you.
No, I never drink and drive. It was my mom's boyfriend. Well, can you?
Well, can I what?
Fix broken things.
That depends on what you broke.
Can you fix airplanes? Careful. Sorry. I just thought that you were going to drop it.
Well, I'll be careful, I promise. You sure you got all the pieces here?
Mostly. One of the bolts rolled off the bed while I was counting. I check them every night just to make sure that they're all here.
What happened to this thing?
It broke.
Really? That's kind of obvious. No, I mean, like, what'd you do? Crash it into a tree or something?
No. Michael broke it.
Michael? Who's that?
He lives with my mom.
So, is he a nice guy? He did this on purpose, huh?
He was mad at me.
What'd you do that made him mad at you?
I don't remember. It was a long time ago.
You kept these pieces all that time, huh?
So, do you think that you could fix it?
Oh yeah, no problem there.
What are you doing? Stop it! What are you gonna do?
Look, Dillan. I know this may be hard for you to understand. In order for me to fix this and get this all together, you're just gonna have to trust me. Can you make a deal on that? Tomorrow. I've got church. Wow. You've got a lot to say there tonight.
Who are you listening to?
The thunder.
I thought you were talking about a person.
I am. How about church? You coming? Or do you have something else you gotta be doing at home?
No, I don't have anything to do. Church would be good.
Just a child, the music would start playing, and we'd step out in the aisle, we'd drink that little cream start first. Crank up the music and let's have church. Crank up the music and let's have church. Let's forget about us. Let's put Jesus first.
Are they gone?
Not yet.
What about the other one? Is he here too?
To Bo? Nah. He's still mourning the loss of his poster collection.
Still? I mean, it's just a bunch of stupid car pictures.
To you, maybe. Paid money for most of those.
I'm sorry. I just didn't think.
Yeah, that's what he said your problem was.
Here's your change. Is he getting drunk?
Something like that.
Them beans ready yet?
Yeah, Pa.
Where you going, boy?
Dad.
Without dinner? Come get some red beans and rice. Shouldn't have stayed out so long.
Am I in trouble?
Could have been. Now come sit up here.
So what kept you?
I wanted to stay out until Bo was gone.
Screw this old set!
I told you, if you boys would lay off of that Mary Jane, you'd have enough money.
Not kid, Pa. Have her heart already.
What? What are you afraid of? He needs to know.
No, he doesn't.
What? You think he's going to throw all his money away sucking on pot?
You want to know where my money goes? Do you want to know where my money goes? Let's talk about all your hospital bills, okay? And then you can lecture me on Mary Jane.
Why do you want to talk to me like that, son?
You're going to lie there waiting on me for your next meal? And you want to lecture me on my hang-ups?
Just fix the TV.
Who's Mary Jane?
Shut up!
To say tonight. Okay. Good night, whoever you are. Just try to keep it down. Thank you.
Sunday.
About that, looks kind of like he's still in bed. Alrighty, well, I'm a little early, but say we go get some breakfast.
Sure.
Alright, let's go. So, how was your first night there in the houseboat?
Wet. The roof leak. I mean the paper leak. I mean, there's no roof at all.
Really? So you got, like, rained on all night?
No, I found this place.
Really? Where?
It's a secret place.
Okay. We have to stay in there sometime, all right?
So, how do you know Egan?
Well, that's kind of a difficult question, really. He and I, his boys there, what's his name in Bo?
Yeah, what's his name is okay, but I don't like Bo at all.
Really, why not?
He's a really bad guy, and he scares me.
Yeah, he has a,
What kind of a problem?
You might call it a heart problem.
Is he gonna die?
Oh, eventually.
Soon?
Yeah, probably.
That's too bad. Does he know?
No, I don't think so.
Then why don't you tell him? You mean there's no way to fix it?
Yeah, there's a way to fix it.
Well, if he's gonna die and you know how to fix it, then why don't you just say something to him?
Well, you see, some people don't like it when you interfere in their lives and in your own business. Bo was one of those type that just wouldn't go for too long if I tried to talk to him.
Great. All right. Green or blue?
What?
Hey, quick. Green or blue, what do you like?
Okay, blue.
Ding, you win the prize. Good thing since they're out of green. How do you like
this? Mm-hmm. Are they for me? What for?
We're going to church. You can't go on that thing. You need to get cleaned up a little bit. So, yeah. Who do you take?
Looking great. Let's come to Jessica. Let me fix that.
pages in a minute. Turn to Psalm 29 and Job 37. The voice of the Lord is powerful and full of majesty. It divideth the flame of fire and causes the wilderness to tremble. He directs his lightning to the ends of the earth. God thundereth marvelously with his voice. He does great things we cannot comprehend. How is God speaking to you? How is he trying to get your attention? You know, he says in here, he's speaking in his thunder. He speaks through the lightning. His voice is upon the waters. God's saying, I'm everywhere. I'm speaking to you through everything. But are we hearing him? And I think today probably God is trying to speak to us even more than he ever has before. But we're not listening. We're missing out completely on what God is trying to say to us. You know, God speaks to us in ways we probably don't even understand. We aren't even thinking about. But, you know, you teenagers, you sit there and you hear your mom or your dad saying to you, you know, don't be going out with that girl. Don't be wearing those kinds of clothing, or don't be listening to that music. You hear it and you think, that's just my parents bothering me. They just say stuff to say stuff. But no, it's really God trying to get your attention and say, hey, wake up. I want to talk with you. I want to share my love with you. I want to share my life with you. You parents, it could be that God is speaking to you through that small voice down by your elbow that's looking up and saying, why are you smoking those little cigarette things? What are those about? You might want to brush it off. You think, oh, that doesn't matter. You know, don't bother me. You know, God says the way we treat those young children is so important. He warns us, he says, those of you who mistreat, who despise my young ones, my little children, he says, it is better for you that a millstone be tied around your neck and you be cast out into the sea than that one of my children should be harmed. It's not funny.
It is.
Yeah, right. What makes it so funny?
You. Because you're a mechanic and your car is like always broken.
Ha ha. I say, old chap. What nice weather we're having today. What say you, we go for a walk, eh?
Right you are, old man. You push while I steer. joking? I told you that it was funny.
Get out, punk.
Horse feathers. So, why didn't you tell me that you were the preacher?
I don't tell too many people that.
Why?
Most people don't like preachers too well.
How come?
We say things they don't like, stuff that kind of convicts them, pricks them right there in their heart.
Things like what?
Oh, you know, drinking, smoking, around, Mary Jane, stuff like that.
You know Mary Jane, too?
Oh, me? No. You?
No.
Huh.
But I heard Grandpa tell Harry and Bo to lay off of her yesterday.
You?
You look cute.
Where were you, old man?
Yeah, we had to string up that fence by ourselves. Thanks for helping us with that, man.
Who'd you walk home with?
Just a guy I met yesterday.
Who?
His name is Jason.
Not the preacher.
Yeah, that's him.
Oh, ooh, you're hanging with the preacher, huh? Reading the good book and stuff?
Little Jesus freak. So cute. You gonna be a priest?
Hey, that'd be good. If he was a priest, we wouldn't have to drive all that way to go confess. We could just do it every day at home.
Before we go to bed.
I don't think you two ever confessed in your entire lives.
He's done his homework, alright?
Yeah, I mean, tell us about our sin, man. I'm real concerned about my salvation. Could you tell me how I could be saved?
You should be with your heart problem. You could die anytime.
You have a heart problem?
News to me. How do you know about this heart problem?
Jason, he knows everything. He talks to God, and God talks back.
Jason's a liar. He doesn't know anything, all right?
He knows about you and Mary Jane.
Listen here, you little creep. You find out about something in this house you don't like, you just keep your mouth shut, all right? Don't look so innocent with this in your face.
Listen.
It's my friend Mary Jane. I'd like to introduce you to her.
To sleep on.
Nothing but trouble.
Beat it!
You're gonna be sorry one day.
Oh, I will, huh? Who's gonna make me sorry?
Jason will make you sorry. Just wait till he finds
you. You mention one word of this to him, and I will kick your butt.
All right then, God is. He'll take care of you. One day you'll ask him for help, and he won't be there. Nobody will.
Yeah, the prophet, he speaks again.
Yeah, Moses, when did you speak to God last?
One day he's going to tell me something really important.
Whatever, dude.
Well, he is.
Oh, great, man. Let us know how that comes out, all right?
God, if you're really there, and you really can hear me, then you know what my problem is. Please don't leave me here with people who hate me.
So, what's the story?
What story?
About this plane. Where'd you get it?
Oh, my dad made it for me a long time ago.
Really? You never told me about your dad. What's he like?
I can't tell you what he's like. I don't remember. He left when I was just a little kid.
So you don't remember anything about him, huh?
I remember that he loved me. That's why he spent all of his time building this plane for me. He was a really good person.
I wouldn't say that if I were you.
Why?
because he took off when you were little and left you. He's far from being a good person.
Don't say that. You don't know what you're talking about.
Look, Dillan. When I was just a little kid, my dad took off too. I thought he was this awesome, great guy as I grew up. I didn't meet him, though, until I was 16 years old. It's the first time I ever saw him. I had all these big dreams, these big, wild ideas. I thought he was this awesome person that was...
Well, when you met him, he was better than your dreams, right?
I don't even know what he was like. I only had 2 minutes with him. Through a glass.
He worked at a bank?
No, he's in jail.
Is he still in jail?
Not anymore.
When was he released?
He wasn't.
I'm sorry.
No, don't be. Just don't want you to think that because your dad's gone, he's gonna be some kind of good person.
What's wrong with thinking that he's a good person?
So, you know you're missing the airplane propeller here, right?
Yeah, I know.
That's gonna be kind of a problem later on when we try and make this thing fly.
Yeah.
Well, I'll look through my scraps, see what I can find.
I really want the old one.
No, you don't have it. It's not here. What, you know where it's at?
Sort of. My dad took it when he left. But somehow it ended up in a pile of his stuff. I just wish that I could... I mean, even if he did happen to turn up, I don't think that he would still have it. I mean, it's just the airplane.
So what's with this flying thing? You want to be a pilot or something?
Well, I don't know. I just want to fly.
Like in an airplane?
No, just fly, like Peter Pan. Because everybody's just way, way down and so tiny. And no one could capture you or keep you, because then you could just fly away.
That's really cool.
Really? You think so? I thought that you were just gonna say it's a silly dream.
Oh, no, it's a great dream. You know, I've never flown, but I think I know something might be just as cool.
What? Come on, tell me what.
Come and fly with me in the shadow of my wings. There's a secret place where the silent voices sing. Come and hear my voice in the stillness of the sky while the thunder echoes. Let me teach you how to fly on the wings of the storm. Soar within the light that waves above the darkest sky. Let me be your shelter in the rain. Let me share your tears. Let me bear your pain. Come and fly with me on the wings of the storm. Stillness of the sky while the thunder echoes. Let me teach you how to fly on the wings of the storm. Let me teach. Let me share your tears. Let me bear your pain. Come and fly with me on the wings of the storm.
How much longer do you think?
Couple more days or so.
Could it be a couple more weeks instead?
Hey, we can come over anytime. You know, you don't have to have an excuse to work on the airplane to come hang out. You know, I might even be able to get you a job over there at the garage.
What?
Oh, sure.
Do I have to smash up anything?
You're good for more than just smashing things, buddy. You know, I have this big pile of important papers and a big bunch of potions that I need shredded up into teeny little pieces. Hey, that was funny. Come on.
No, it wasn't.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, so when I do something stupid, it's funny. And when you leave your headlights on, it's all, oh, my car won't start, so my light sucks.
Hey. Hey, stick it.
No, stop.
Your sweater. Yeah, let me take a look at it. A scratch, huh?
Okay, it's a bruise.
Yeah, it's like size of my hand type of bruise. What happened?
I fell out of the garret when I was sleeping.
I'm sorry. I've been a little more careful. Sorry about that, buddy. Hey, I'll take you home. Come on. So, how's your little experiment coming?
What experiment?
You know, about hearing from God.
Oh, that. No. I just think that he's too far away. I mean, there's sky, and then outer space, and then wherever he is above that. Or maybe he just doesn't hear as well as he used to. I mean, he's pretty old, isn't he? Anyway, it's just a stupid idea.
Says who?
Harry and Bo.
Told them about it?
Yeah. I felt like such an idiot. God's gonna talk to you one day. Na 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 na. But they were smoking these tiny little... Wait. They said for me not to tell that to you. Promise you won't tell them I said that to you.
So in all your talking to them, you didn't happen to mention what I said about Bo dying, did you?
You should have seen his face.
You did?
Why? Was that bad? I was just trying to preach like you.
Look, there's this little thing called tact. You use it whenever someone's about to punch you in the face.
Does it happen a lot?
Pretty much any time you tell someone the truth and they don't really want to hear it.
Oh, that's what you meant by a heart problem. I thought you meant like his heart. Like his heart. But he could die any time, or be killed, or something. Or Grandpa could die first, because Harry said that he might have a heart attack really soon. You know, one time they were fighting, and I thought that they were about to kill each other.
Why don't we talk about something else?
I'm just trying to be prepared, okay? Because everything else in my life is just, hey, I'm going to dump you here, bye. Or, hey, have a smashed airplane. At least with dying, you know it's coming. So, do you want me to be serious and talk about dead people, or be funny and talk about your car problems?
Let's stick to dead people.
Well, about time you showed up. Who's this with you?
Hey there, Mr. McCain. I'm Jason Bates. I don't know if you remember me.
Oh, yeah, the accident.
Accident?
Here, this came for you. Can I offer you anything? Maybe a glass of water?
Try a cup of milk.
No, thanks. I'm good. Appreciate it. So, sorry about your leg there.
Thanks a lot. That fixes everything. What's new in town?
Oh, figure your boys would be keeping you up on that.
Wherever it is in town, they spend all their time. I don't even want to know. Any news?
Well, about 2 years ago, I started preaching there at Little Creek.
You? I wouldn't think the church committee would even go for a man with your background.
Yeah, well, they went for you.
So how are you getting along over there?
Doing all right. Sermons are a little different than the way you did it.
How?
Well, I tend to come down really, hit people close to home. They get a little uncomfortable with what I have to say.
So how's the attendance?
It's kind of low.
Well, you know you got to tell them what they want to hear.
I ain't preaching to make them all feel warm and fuzzy. If they can't handle the truth, then they can leave.
Well, it's your tithe money.
You sleep good at night?
Nah. That's why I'm so exhausted all day.
So, suppose you remember the night then that Dillan fell out of the garret there.
Never fallen out of the garret.
Yeah, I didn't think so.
He's got a big old bruise on his side. Any idea where that may have come from?
Yeah, well, you know, we all have accidents, okay? Someone with your driving record should understand perfectly. You know how boys are.
Yeah, I know how your boys are.
Just what are you saying?
I'm saying I think they're beating him up.
Oh, so now you've turned social worker too, huh?
No.
Then tell me what right you got coming in here and start accusing my boys right here in my face.
I've gotten to know Dillan pretty good these past few weeks. I'm not going to stand by and watch a bunch of potheads beating him up.
You watch your mouth, young man. What goes on here is none of your business.
I'm warning you. You take better care of him or else...
Well, what? If anybody's going to call the police, it's going to be me. Now, you said what you came to say. Now, get off my property.
Now, you listen here. All I'm saying is you take better care of him. That boy deserves a little more compassion and love. If you can't handle that, then I'll find some better place for him to stay.
I want you to stay away from him.
He's just my friend. He's trying to fix my airplane.
Are you kidding? That young man runs everything. Out to the field, and you have the boys, and start earning your keep. You understand me?
Yes, sir.
Come here, Dillan. I'm sorry I shouted. You may not know it, but your grandpa really does love you.
Then why do you let Bo and Harry do whatever they want?
Well, you can see. I'm not really in a position to tell them what to do. I have to keep on their good side, or else I don't eat.
But aren't you worried about them? They'll be caught someday. The police will take them away from you.
No, no, no. God wouldn't let that happen. I asked him to protect them. Now listen here. I know that preacher boy's been proselytizing you. I know a thing or two about God myself, and I know that he's pure love. He doesn't punish people.
It's just that it hurts when somebody you love goes to jail.
Oh, come on now. I know you're not that worried about Harry and Bo. The only way anything bad could happen is if Jason Bates calls the cops on us.
He wouldn't do that. Would he?
I told you, your grandpa knows what's best. Hey, Clacker, you finished down there yet?
Almost.
You better be finished by the time I get down there, you little turd. Looks good.
seriously, I would have done it in a heartbeat.
But why? You barely even know me.
I know, but there's someone once that did the same thing for me. I barely knew him too.
Who was it?
It's Jesus. See, back in Jesus' time, the way they killed people was they'd take them. They would beat them until they're almost dead. They'd stick them up on a cross, pound these nails in their hands, through their feet, and hang them up like that to die.
What did he do to deserve all of that?
Nothing. He didn't deserve one bit of it, but he loved us so much. He didn't want us to be separated from him. To have to spend eternity in punishment that we deserve because of all the bad stuff we've ever done in our lives.
So, does that mean that I'm forgiven for all the bad things that I've ever done?
No, not exactly. You see, you still have a choice you gotta make.
Profit, huh?
Talk to the man upstairs lately?
You'd be surprised.
You think the man downstairs might have something to say?
So what you got in your backpack, son?
This is my airplane.
Where'd you get it? Did you steal it?
No, I had it when I got here. I just didn't want to show it to you.
Can I see it? Oh, yeah. Pretty good work for a preacher.
I did some of it, too.
I understand you gave the boys a little rough time with the fence today, though.
I didn't do anything bad.
No, he just did half-butt work and then lied about it and almost got Harry slashed in the face. That's all.
It could have been a lot worse.
Like what?
Like sit on my brain smoking my life away?
Listen here, I'm tired of your holier than thou attitude, okay? You come here with nothing and you expect us to feed you and you're gonna be better than me?
What are you gonna do?
What do you think?
No, you would not make me break my promise!
I'm gonna break your face! Look what you did! You know how much this stuff cost me?
I don't care.
Of course you don't care. You just come here, you destroy stuff. You're lucky there's nothing of yours that...
Told you I'd be around.
How does it feel, Hobo? Going around and beating up kids just in front of it, huh? Let me show you how it feels!
Oh. Rough stuff, preacher. Is this the gentle Jesus meek and mild?
No, Harry. This is one of those millstone moments.
I told you once, Mr. Bates, stay off of my property.
You have 10 seconds to get off this property, or I swear to God, I'll blow your head off!
Or I'm going. But I'll be back for him.
on, dear Jesus. Speak to me now. I need to hear your voice. Please, speak to me.
Can you tell me how you know?
I heard it. They're on their way here.
No, stop it, all right? I'm not going anywhere until you tell me how you found out. Now, who told you?
God. It was God who told me.
God told you? God told you. Are you hearing this, Paul? God told him. God spoke to him.
Please, I have a hiding spot. Why won't anybody believe me?
I believe you.
What?
I believe you, Dillan. Yeah, I believe too. Oh, I believe. Oh, yes, Brother Dillan, I believe. I mean, this judgment is so great. Can you tell me how I can be saved, Pastor Dillan?
Dillan, where was that safe place you were talking about?
Yes, Uncle Harry?
Dillan, I'm so sorry for the way that we treated you.
Are you asking me to forgive you?
Something like that.
Well, I think that you should go to God for forgiveness.
I don't know. I just don't think I can do that.
Why not?
I'm just too wicked.
I know.
No, you don't know. You have no idea what I'm involved in when I leave this house.
It doesn't matter to God. He knows all about that stuff anyway. All you have to say is, God, I know that I am so wicked. Please forgive me. And that's it.
What happened?
Mo, my little boy. You came back. I don't want that stuff in this house. You hear me? Get rid of it. They're going to get you for it. They'll take you away. Please don't do this to me.
Grandpa, it's me.
Bo?
No, Bo's not here.
Where did he go?
Bo's in jail, Grandpa. They took him away.
My boy is gone?
I'm here, Grandpa.
Who are you?
Grandpa, I'm Dillan.
Dillan? Marsha's boy? You used to be so tiny. You're a good boy.
No, I'm not.
You don't know why you came here.
Yes, I do. Mom dumped me here because she was trying to get away from the cops.
No. God sent you here. God sent you here to warn us.
But it didn't do any good. You didn't listen to me.
I wish I could be there to see what God does with your life.
Grandpa, no! Grandpa!
It was my fault. Dad. Dad. I know you can't hear me. I love you so much. I love you so much.
Those of you who knew Inga McCain before his accident, I encourage you to remember him, how he was. Kind, jovial, good-hearted person. But for those of us who knew him after his accident, I think he'd want us to know that no matter how far you've gone, how low your life has come, you're never too far to be out of the reach of the grace of God. Your secret place, huh?
Yes.
So, that's where you heard from God, huh?
Whatever.
Well, you don't believe God really spoke to you now?
Unless you think God says stuff like, I have this really pointless message to give these people, and no one will listen to you. Is that something God would say?
You're not really understanding God very well yet, I don't think.
No, I guess not.
I mean, besides, you said it was pointless. I mean, Harry listened to you.
And Bo is in jail. And Grandpa.
You know, everything happens to us for a reason, Dillan. Maybe it's just God wants to prove to you that he's real. Have you ever thought of that before?
He killed a good man. Just to prove that he's real?
No, Dillan. He spoke to you to prove that he's real. And my grandpa wasn't a good person.
Why do you always say that about people? Can't some people be good? Why does everybody that loves me have to be a bad person?
Not everybody who loves you is bad, Dillan.
Sure. My mom just lives in jail because she can't pay rent.
No, that's not what I meant. Come on, can't you think of anybody else who cares about you? Even just a little?
Nope. Unless you're thinking of the guy that called the cops on us. You probably think he did the right thing.
How do you know about that?
I heard it on the police radio last night. They said that it was a guy in town. I just wish I knew who it was.
What do you want to know that for?
Because it's his fault that all of this happened.
No. Dillan, listen to me. They made their own choices, and that's what the outcome was. You shouldn't go around getting upset at people just because they're doing the right thing, especially since he was just trying to help you.
How do you know that? How do you know that?
It was me. I called the police.
Grandpa told me I shouldn't have trusted you.
Dillan! Come back! Dillan! Dillan!
Keeping it. What am I waiting for? Like God's gonna listen to me. All this time I've been praying and praying, and he won't give me the one thing I've asked for.
What do you want?
I want my dad. What do you think?
And I've told you, quit putting your dad up on a pedestal. You don't know what he was like before.
I don't care. He's my dad.
You really don't care at all?
Of course not. I know that he loved me, and I love him. And he's the only one with the last piece.
Call how many always gonna need your care, always wanting you beside me, cause as long as you're there, I can fly without fear, I can fall without pain, I can spread out my wings to the wind and the rain, I can come to you broken and leave in repair, I can fall without fear, just as one day the wind will catch me and I'll soar above it all. But until that day, I need you to be here when I fall. I can fly without fear, I can fall without pain, I can spread out my wings to the wind and the rain, I can come to you broken and leave and repair, I can fall without fear, just as long as you're there. I can come to you broken and leave in repair. I can flow without fear, just as long as you're there.